So good morning, students. And we are doing our unit 1, which is about digital documentation. And yes, this is the session 2, which is entitled by images and uses in document. So in the previous classes, I have told you how you can insert an image and you can manipulate it accordingly. You can insert the image in several ways, just like you can image the insert the image from insert tab. By control plus C, by control plus C, that means copying and pasting the images. And then I have told you how you can insert and manipulate, and you can use the different kind of objects. In objects, I mean that how you can use circle, rectangle, parallelogram, arrows, and etc. So these are the facilities which is provided by the LibreOffice Writer or any other Word document. So the very first question come in our mind that what is the basic application and or what is the basic uses of these images and objects. So the simple answer is that once we are enhancing our document, once we are we want that our document should be presentable, should be eye-catching, so that then we use the images and objects. Supposedly, if you want to show any kind of flow chart, any kind of data flow diagram in which you you are portraying how data is flowing. Supposedly, you are creating a maths problem or a maths document, then you will find that you need several kind of objects, just like parallelogram, rectangle, circles, oval, arrows, and etc. So for doing that, we use the objects. Supposedly, if you are preparing any kind of Word document related to history, SST or English, so in which you can portray, you can convey your message, you can convey your things by images also, because images speak more than text. You know that it? Okay, so this is the basic simple rule or basic simple application you can say for images and object. Because I am asking this, I am discussing this point because it's been asked in the previous exam, once it held in offline method. So ye pucha gaya tha ki why we are using images and object in any kind of word processing document. So this is the basic answer, this is the very simple answer you can give. So now continuing the session number 2, which is about images and uses in document. So now we are going to understand how we can position our image within the text. Okay. So when we paste, when we insert any kind of image in our text document, it do not allow automatically that we can set the image according to us. Supposedly here I am fixing my image, okay, here in the line of positioning of an image. Once I have pasted the image here, it will not move according to me. But how to facilitate us that we can manipulate it, we can fix our image according to us. So we need to anchor it, we need to wrap it, or we need to position it. Okay, mark my point. I'm using two types of computing terminologies. First one is that anchor, A-N-C-H-O-R, anchor. And the second term I am using is wrap. Okay, anchoring means which point on which thing we are going to paste our image. If we are going to insert our image to paragraph, then it will be referred as anchoring to paragraph. Mark my point, students. Okay, if we are going to insert any image related to paragraph that is being settled with the help of paragraph, so it will be referred as anchoring to paragraph. Okay, if we are anchoring, if we are setting any image regarding to any text, then it will be referred as anchoring to characters. Okay, hope you have understood what is anchoring to characters and anchoring to paragraph. Both have different scenarios. If we are going to set anchoring to paragraph, then it will facilitate us how we can manipulate our image, how we can set our image regarding to our paragraph. So it will be automatically set it to what? Paragraph. And yes, if we are applying our anchoring, if we are applying or inserting our image towards the character, then it will be set according to our text only. Supposedly for line, for one word, for one sentence, and etc. Okay, so this is the basic prerequisite which I have told you before describing positioning images with text. So let's start the theoretically. When we add an image to a text document, we need to choose how to position it with respect to the text and other images. Okay, So we need to position it. You don't want to set your image, you don't want to insert your image just in a bulky way or in a rough way. Okay. So the positioning of image is often rather time consuming and may be very frustrating for both inexperienced and as well as for experienced users also. Yes. When I was doing BCA or I was in Tasu, I also found a very difficult thing to position an image because it's quite frustrating. It was not set by me. Why? Because I am not experienced in that thing. Supposedly, I want to place my image here simultaneously with this positioning image in with text. It was not set by me automatically because I didn't know the tools. So once you are familiar with the tools, once you are wrapping and anchoring, then you can understand how you can position your text. Okay. So sometimes it may be frustrating for experienced as well as inexperienced users also. So it needs practice first of all. As Writer is a word processor, then a desktop publishing program, there are some limitations to the flexibility in positioning images. And it takes time to get things exactly as we would like them. Yes. Our book has already mentioned that it will take time. Okay. Why it will take time? Because it is a word processor. It is not any kind of image processor. If it is a kind of image processor, then it will process the image very quickly. But as we are working on word processor, then it will take some time. Mark my point, it will take some time, a few time. Okay. So for positioning of an image is controlled by four settings. So we are considering only four settings. Arrangement refers to placement of an image on an imaginary vertical axis. Arrangement controls how images are stacked upon each other or relative to the text. As I have told you, that you need to care about how you are going to treat your image. If you are inserting more than one images, then you have to take care that which image should come first and which image should come in the vertical axis, which image you want to display as a horizontal axis. So it's up to you. Okay. And then alignment. What do you mean by alignment? Alignment means the exact position towards the right, towards the left, or towards the up, or towards the bottom line. Okay. So this refers to the alignment. Anchoring, as I have told you, anchoring means the point. The point could be the page, frame, paragraph, even a character also. So the point in which we are going to insert, we are going to emphasize our image is referred as anchoring. It may be a paragraph anchoring, it may be a character anchoring. Okay. And yes, text wrapping. Text wrapping means how we are wrapping our text towards the image. Okay. So supposedly if I want the image in middle and I want text in right section also, in left section also, then I will apply text wrapping. Supposedly, if I want my image very flexible, flexible means what? I am inserting, I am writing text also as well as pasting the, as well as inserting the images also. So for that, I will use what? Text wrapping. Okay. So as you can understand here from screen also, that text wrapping refers to the relation of images to the surrounding text, which may wrap around the graphic on one or both sides, as I have told you. Okay. So it's up to you. It may be overprinted behind or in front of the graphic or treat the graphic as a separate paragraph or character. So this is the steps. This is the major points you need to understand. You need to care about whenever you are dealing with positioning of an image. Okay. And mark my point, students, this is very important topic as it's already came in your board examination. How you can position your images or how you can position your objects. Okay. So it is very important topic. The settings can be accessed in a number of ways depending on the nature of the images. Okay. So how you can deal or how you can access the tools for wrapping, for anchoring and for image processing. So the very first thing is that you need to click on format menu. Once you have inserted any kind of image, then you will allow to access our format menu, as I have told you in the previous classes also. Okay. So where you can find anchor, wrap and arrange, etc. And yes, if you are not familiar with the format menu, then you can go to the context menu also by right clicking the image. Very simple, as we do in daily life also. For images from the type and rear page of the image dialog box, note that we cannot control the arrangement using the dialog. To open the image dialog, click the image to select it and choose format, then go to the image. Then you have to select on properties, or instead of doing this lengthy process, you can also right click the image also. Okay. For drawing object, now we are concentrating about the object, that means rectangle, square, circular, etc. So from the position and size page of the position and size dialog, to open the dialog, once again what you need to do is you need to right click the drawing object. That's it. Then you can access the tools. Students, mark my point that I am describing all these steps theoretically here. Now I will share my screen also. Okay, so don't worry, I will implement the practical portion also. Okay, and this is about the calc spreadsheet or draw document. This is also in our syllabus, as it will come later, so that's why I'm not describing this portion. Okay, this bullet. So we can move around the image on the page but cannot shift from the page. Okay, and now the next set of pictures is to check for wrapping of image around text and etc. So this is how we will complete the session number 2, which is about images and uses in the document. So now it's all about the theoretical portion. Now I'm going to share my screen to display how you can position your images. So here we are in the LibreOffice interpreter, or you can say the interface. So now first we need to insert image. So here insert, where I have clicked, I have clicked here in insert. Then go to the image. Here I am pasting this tiranga.png. Here it is. I have inserted my image. Okay. Now, supposingly I am writing some text or paragraphs. Yeah. Public school Bikaner is Anya Institute. Okay, I have selected this paragraph. Supposing from here, pasting here, just for the sake of example. Okay, I'm not going to save it here. So here you can see we have written so much portion of text also, and here is our image. Okay, so now from here, once I have clicked on the image, now you will find this toolbar for image. Okay, or you can go to here, format. Okay, and there you can find the image and properties. So it is loading here. You can wrap it here, you can create crop it, area, transparency, macro, and etc. Okay, so this is the properties, and if I am right clicking on it, so here I can find anchor, wrap, align objects, arrange, rotate or flip, and etc. And here I can also find the properties also. So this is the several kind of method by which you can access to properties. So here what I was going to tell you, that anchoring, once I am right clicking on it, I can access to the anchor. Now you can see that it is being anchored to the character. So what it will happen if I have anchoring it to the paragraph? Okay, it doesn't change, but now it will fix according to the paragraph only. Okay, it will now fix to the paragraph. In the previous section, in the previous anchoring, it being set to the text only. So now it will set it according to paragraph. Okay, and this is the wrap. Wrap, that means optimal. Optimal means I can write to left side and right side also. Parallel. And here, supposedly I am copying this data from here. Here you can see. Here you can see that our image is not being affected, and I can add more data or I can add more text. Okay, the basic, the very important wrapping is that through. Okay, you can select it through, so you can move it anywhere in the page document wherever you want to place it. Okay, so the basic or the major or the most frequently used wrap style is through. Why I am saying that? Because it is very flexible, and for doing that you can hover the mouse anywhere in the screen and it will be placed, it will place your image anywhere in the document. Okay, there are several kind of options, none, parallel, before means what? You can write after the text, or before the text. And if you will select wrap in after, that means first it will place image and then you can start writing the text. Okay, through in background also. I am showing you the background only. Here I am wrapping it as a background. Okay, here you can see the background also. Okay, so this is a wrapping, this is the anchoring you can do with the help of image processing. So I hope that you have understood how you can insert an image as well as you can wrap it, you can anchor it. Okay, here you can also find the anchoring. Okay, here you can find the wrapping, none, parallel, optimal, before, after, and through. The align object, that means where you want to put the images, to the left side, to right side, bring to front. This is meaning that where you want to align the object. Okay, and if you want to insert any kind of object, then you can access from here. Supposedly I want to insert any kind of triangle, then I can draw it here. Okay, so this is how we have completed our unit 2 by practical manner also and by theoretical manner also. So after completing session 2, now we are going to start session number 3, which is about create and use template. Yes, whenever we are discussing about templates, though, so that means we are going to use any kind of pre-built or already built Word document. Okay, template is nothing but a kind of draft that we use for our daily life. Okay, supposedly that we don't want to create our own style, we don't want to create some customization to own, we just want to take a template from auto build section and then start writing and then we are done. So for that point of view, we can use templates. Template is nothing but auto built or pre-built Word document in which we create it, we manipulate it, and we modify it also. Okay, so a template is a document model. Mark my point, it is not a complete document, it is a document model that we use to create other documents. Yes, absolutely. And for example, we can create a template for business reports that has our company's logo on the first page, or new documents created from this template. So just be simple. Supposingly I am working here in Laya Public School, and daily I need to deal with 10 to 12 PDF, or I need to deal with 5 to 10 Word documents. So instead of creating again and again a document, I can create a template and then can access it twice or multiple times. Okay, so this is the basic logic behind using, or this is the basic application of using template. Okay, so new documents created from this template will have our company's logo on the first page. Okay, and templates can contain anything that regular documents can contain. So that means templates is not different from the other document. It can contain text, graphics. What do you mean by graphics? That means we can include images or documents, or sometimes GIF also. Okay, a set of styles, a user specific setup information such as measurement units, languages, the default printer and toolbar, and menu customization. So all that you can do in a simple Word document, you can also do in templates also. It is a kind of document model that we use to create the other documents. Okay, as simple as its definition suggests. And using the templates to create a document, now we will discuss how we can use a template. So yes, as usual, first we will discuss it through theoretical manner, then we will jump to the practical portion. So for creating a document from template dialog box, okay, so for that we need to click on menu bar, where you will find file, go to new, select templates or click on the small arrow next to the new icon on the standard toolbar and select templates. From the filters list at the top of the templates dialog, optionally select a category. So you can select a category also. There are so many kinds of category available in our LibreOffice Writer. So from there you can access different kind of templates. Find and double click on the required templates. A new document based on the selected templates open your writer, and we can then edit and save the new document just as we would in any other document. As simple as the theory suggesting. So now I'm going to share my screen so I can show you how you can insert any kind of templates. So here is our menu bar. Here is file. Here is the new. And once I am clicking on this small arrow, here I can find templates. Or you can find your templates by clicking Ctrl plus Shift plus N over there. Here is the filter. From this, you can find several kind of templates. For documents, yes, we are emphasizing on the documents only. So that's why our default filter is set to the documents. And what if I need to create a CV? Then I will double click it. That's it. Once I have double clicked it, here you can see a curriculum vishay, that means CV, is already been inserted here. So as you can see that in name block, I can see this job blocks and etc. So I can manipulate it, I can modify it according to me. Okay, so this is the basic logic, this is the basic application of using the templates. So in the upcoming session, in upcoming classes, I will tell you how you can access different tools, different accessibility tools for using templates. So I hope you have enjoyed this session. Take care. Bye-bye.